And this is my stain screen area in the middle of Mills. Okay, so let's see what we got here. We got Survival Guy, Fluff, Brain Treats, French Fries. Okay, so we've got 5 haunted houses, Terracotta Empress, Hex, Make the Cut, Inside the Mind, Death Mall, 2 shows, Laboratorium, Slice of Life, then only 2 scare zones, Happy Horror Days, and Pilgrimage of Sins. I'm down with that. And the event is about to start. Oh, look at that!
Get ready.
There's a mall that just opened and it had structural failing. It had one of the biggest fears of mine, which is mannequins. When I get a computer later, I'll be able to upload the footage that I filmed in there. You can check out The Pilgrimage of Sin, which is playing music from Eyes Wide Shut. While the haunted houses are a bit limited here, they are extremely violent and extremely, it's what they don't show you. There's some minimalist stuff in there. There was a whole room that's, you can hear the guy saying, I'm stuck in my own mind, and there's like lasers coming down, like you're trapped. I got so scared because I was impressed with the minimalist visuals of this haunted house. Sometimes it's what you don't show that's scary. Well, I can see the idea of riding the Battlestar Galactica ride at night. It's probably awesome. Make the cut. This is the Korean K-pop band Haunted House, which that was really hard to say because when do you ever say that? Remember how I said that was one of the more unique things to say about a haunted house? That was a really unique haunted house. You're going through a sound studio and you were trying to make the cut. There was a girl with scissors in there trying to cut your head off. And I can only think of Hollow Scream doing that. They did that a couple of years ago. People going through, like you're trying to get backstage. That was really unique. And outside of the mummy area, there is a haunted house called Hex. That X, Hex. There was a scare actor that commented on my YouTube page that said, who's in here? And he was waiting to scare me. We'll see how that worked. That was a trip. There was a part in there where a woman asked to have a baby, so a demon popped out of her chest. There was a woman that wanted to kill these guys because they thought they were snakes, so a whole busload of snakes covered the bus, a big giant snake of man. I will say that these haunted houses are a little more, I'd say, intense. They seem really violent and very direct. Garbage day in here. Christmas, everyone. Jesus. Not sure what day this is, but this whole area is kind of like a haunted house. It's got its own free form, go wherever you want to go, feel. Because it's an actual maze in a scare zone.
Oh, it's not close at all.
Can't really see it, but there's a hedge maze here. that you're going through and there's little rabbits getting in through it.
That was a unique take on a scare zone. It was more haunted house than scare zone, and they actually had guides to guide you through it and say, go here this way, go that way, after you were done. So, good on them.
Last and final house of the night is probably interesting to people from China. This is the Terracotta Empress, which involves some history, but I only know the Terracotta War. Wow, if I knew more about Chinese history, I think I'd be more impressed.
But that was also stellar. Once again, it doesn't look like you're walking into a Hollywood set for these things, but it does feel like you're in the time. It seriously felt like you were in a tomb with the Terracotta Warriors that are surrounding you. It was pretty intense. I filmed all the haunted houses covertly with my little glasses camera. I'm very excited to see how it all turns out because I think the houses here are really interesting and pretty gory. However, I will not be able to see them until I'm back in Japan. Am I back at Disney World?
Wait, they have a Halloween version of Shrek?
I feel a little tricked because that was just a made-for-TV movie that they played, and it was pretty bad. However, since there's only two scare zones, this majority of the park is absolutely dead.
However, the scare zones and haunted houses more than double make up for that. That opening was pretty cool. It's a shame that they're not all out all the time.
But given the fact that I've done all the haunted houses, done all the scare zones, seen everything except for the shows, I think it's time for me to head on home because, well, I've been here all day and I'm tired. But as they always say, folks, you can do it, I can do it, we can all do it. But never worry, never fear, I'll be back to see more horror this year.